We want to solve the compound inequality and then express using interval notation. Looking at our compound inequality, notice how it looks like we have two inequalities combined together. When written in this form, this represents two inequalities connected by AND. If we start in the middle, one of the inequalities would be from left to right, as we see here in red, and the other one is from the middle, reading from right to left. So notice in blue we would have 3 minus 4x is greater than negative 13. And in red we have 3 minus 4x is less than or equal to 1. Notice in blue the inequality symbol is pointing toward the negative 13, and notice that it still is here. So these two are equivalent. So now we're going to solve both of these inequalities, graph them both on the number line, and then interpret the graph to determine when both inequalities would be true because it's an AND. Looking at our first inequality in blue, we want to isolate x, so the first step here is going to be to undo this positive 3 by subtracting 3 on both sides. This would be 0, so we have negative 4x is greater than negative 16, and now we're going to divide both sides by negative 4, and remember, when solving an inequality, if we divide or multiply by a negative number, we do have to reverse the inequality symbol. So this would be x, but we'll reverse this inequality, so instead of greater than, it will be less than, and then negative 16 divided by negative 4 is positive 4. So now let's go ahead and graph x as less than 4 in blue on the number line. Notice that 4 does not satisfy this inequality and therefore is not in the interval. So we make an open point on positive 4, and then for less than 4 we have an arrow to the left. And now we'll solve the inequality in red and do the same. So again, the first step will be to subtract 3 on both sides. Be 0, so we have negative 4x is less than or equal to 1 minus 3 is negative 2, and now we'll have to divide both sides by negative 4, and again we're dividing by a negative, so we'll have to reverse the inequality symbol. So this will be x, instead of less than or equal to, it'll be greater than or equal to, and then negative 2 divided by negative 4 would be positive 2/4 or positive 1/2. So x is greater than or equal to positive 1/2. Well, 1/2 would be somewhere in here on the number line. Notice that positive 1/2 does satisfy this inequality, so we make a closed point on positive 1/2. And then for numbers greater than 1/2, we have an arrow to the right. Now this is not the graph of our solution. Remember, we want the interval that would satisfy both inequalities because they're connected by AND. Graphically, that means we want the interval that's graphed both in red and in blue, and you can see it's going to be the numbers between 1/2 and 4, including 1/2 but not including 4, or this interval here. So let's go ahead and clean this up so it's very clear which interval is the solution. Again, it's the interval between these two. So if we wanted to express this using interval notation, we have the interval from 1/2 to 4. It's closed on 1/2 because it includes 1/2, so we make a square bracket. And it's open on 4 because it does not include 4, so we use a rounded parenthesis. So now we've expressed the solution three ways: as two inequalities connected by AND, as a graph, and using interval notation. Now I should mention that we could express Now I do want to mention we could express the solution as a compound inequality similar to the form that was given to us. Notice x is the interval between 1/2 and 4, closed on 1/2 and open on 4. So we could express this as x is less than 4 and greater than or equal to 1/2. So you may see the solution expressed this way as well. Of course, it means the same thing as x is less than 4 and x is greater than or equal to 1/2. I hope you found this helpful.